Now, WYFF News 4, live local breaking news at 11.
We begin tonight with continuing coverage on that big break in the North Carolina missing hikers case.
Today, investigators confirmed the remains found near Franklin, North Carolina on Saturday are those of John Bryant. His wife Irene's body was found November 9th, about 2 hours away in the Pisgah National Forest. Tonight, we talked to the man who helped bring the Bryant family some closure. Mark Waldrop was walking in the woods when he noticed something that looked like a skull and then called 911.
And the more I looked at it, the more it looked like it could be a human skull. And, of course, I didn't believe that could be possible. It was pretty scary, you know. Of course, you first thought is foul play, or, you know, you don't know what could have happened. Well, it's a great thing for the family that they could have some closure, I believe.
News 4's Mandy Gaither continues with our top story tonight. Mandy, you talked to some of the couple's friends.
Well, that's right, and tonight they have mixed emotions. Investigators were able to identify John Bryant not only by his dental records, but also from his pacemaker. They matched the serial number on it. I talked to their longtime neighbors who tonight say they're happy to at least have some closure, especially for the family.
Beneath the yellow crime scene tape off an isolated road near Franklin, North Carolina, you can still see small markers pointing out evidence. This is the place where John Bryant's remains were found. For those closest to him and his wife, Irene, it was a bittersweet discovery.
You're glad, but you're sad. It just kind of breaks your heart that these fine people, this happened to them.
Matt and Ann Madison knew the Bryants for more than 15 years. They live across the street from the couple's home. Now it only serves as a reminder of their gruesome deaths. Irene found beaten to death in the Pisgah National Forest. There's still no word on how John was killed.
It's very difficult for me to think that they're not, you know, going to come back, that they just haven't gone on a long trip.
The Madisons knew something wasn't right when they, with John and Irene's son, broke into the couple's home after seeing their newspapers piling up.
And you could see that there was, that they had just perhaps gone out for a hike and expected to come back.
Now they're ready for what happens next. Charges have not yet been filed against the only suspect, Gary Michael Hilton, but authorities say there's no question in their minds he killed the couple.
And I just hope that they prosecute him to the utmost.
And for this couple who in life were never too far apart from each other, friends now hope in death they'll be able to be buried together.
Investigators still aren't releasing when or where John died or whether his body was dumped near Franklin. They tried to talk to the suspect, Hilton, but say he didn't have much to tell them and asked for an attorney. We're told they only wanted to talk to him to get to the location of John's body, but they already have enough evidence to link him to the case. Michael.
And Mandy, some background now. This case does date to October when the Bryants first disappeared, and here's a look at how it's all unfolded. On October 21st, a call came from the couple's cell phone. Though it never went to dispatchers, the next day, October 22nd, someone used the Bryants' ATM card in Tennessee, and a surveillance camera captured that person wearing Mr. Bryant's yellow jacket. The search for the Bryants officially started November 6th after family members notified the sheriff's office. On November 9th, searchers found the body of Irene Bryant. She had been killed with multiple blows to the head. Then on January 16th, investigators made a positive link between that man there, Gary Michael Hilton, and this case. He was sentenced to life in prison just last week for killing a hiker in Georgia. And tonight we have confirmation. Skeletal remains found in the Natahala National Forest on Saturday are those of John Bryant. A reminder, you can check our website for previous stories, video on this case. Just check the front page there at WYFF4.com.